بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Verse 27 from Surah Al-A'raf and 28, inshallah tonight. These two verses has a message also for the sons of Adam, children of Adam. And Surah Al-A'raf, the chapter of the height. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا بَنِي آدَمْ لَا يَفْتِنَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ كَمَا أَخْرَجَ أَبَوَيْكُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ ينزع عنهما لباسهما ليريهما سوآتهما إنه يراكم هو وقبيله من حيث لا ترونهم إنا جعلنا الشياطين أولياء للذين لا يؤمنون. The meaning of this verse, it's a call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the children of Adam. He said, oh children of Adam, do not let the shaitan, Satan, deceive you and put you in trouble as he removed your parents, Adam and Eve, out of paradise. Having their dress removed from them to show them their shame and private parts. Indeed, he Shaitan, Satan, Iblis, a devil, and his company, Dhurriya, descendants from the jinn or his tribe, see you from where you do not see them. Tabdi haga, yani muhimma, we know this. Indeed, we made the devil's friends, نجعلنا الشيطان أولياء, allies, helpers, friends to those whom do not believe, للذين لا يؤمنون. Let's see this verse number 27 and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, be careful, be away from الشيطان. And when he's telling you, oh children of Adam, he's telling you, remember your father Adam. I said that before, like he said, يا بني إسرائيل. He said, يا بني آدم. Our children of Jacob, Yaqub, your father, Bani Israel, your Jacob father, he was a good man. Be good like him. Our children of Adam, Ya Bani Adam, remember Adam and his animosity with the Shaitan, Iblis. And the Shaitan threatened Adam and his descendants until the day of judgment that he will work hard to take too many of human beings, children of Adam, with him to the hellfire because he hates Adam so much. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, be aware, remember, don't forget about that. And he said, لا يفتننكم. What is the fitna? الفتنه هي الاختبار, to be examined. This is called الفتنه. كاختبار الذهب بالنار. When you put the gold in the fire to purify the gold from the copper, from too many things, called الفتنه. الفتنه itself, it is not bad if you pass it. If you pass the fitna, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created us with a fitna, with al-ikhtibar, liyakhtabirukum, liyabluwakum, liyabluwakum makum ahsan amala. Fitna, we are in fitna already. The problem, people will be two types when they see the fitna. I don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see it. Yes, because this is not easy. Fitna to be examined. Like you have the exam, some of us will pass, some of us will fail. And if you pass the fitna, that fitna will make you strong, mashallah, and you become okay. But if you fail, most people, they are big failure in fitna. That's why al fitna has khair side, good, and bad side too. Yani, subhanallah. If you pass it, we'll be okay. If not, this is a big problem. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was giving Adam and Eve Jannah, it was not the Jannah which is, we're going to go in the end, inshallah, for eternity in it. No. The Jannah, it was a small Jannah garden for Adam and Eve to live there to be examined, to be trained. To be trained where? Why and where? To be trained because Allah promised Adam already, I'm going to make you Khalifa on earth. Before even he put him in Jannah. إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ Khalifa. He said that. Before even he created Adam, he said, I'm going to make a representative for me, Khalifa for me on earth. Means already it's ready for Adam to go to the earth. That small Jannah for him, it was not the eternal Jannah what Allah promised us. No. It was somewhere on earth, and this earth could be in India because Adam was there already. Allah A'lam, in very high place, and he was there. He'd been examined, trained to what? Trained to take al-manhaj. If'al wa la taf'al. He said, wa la taqraba. And he ate from the tree. Allah gave him order, don't go near to the tree. If'al. Huh? Don't do it. Don't la taf'al. Don't do it. But he did. He disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amr wa nahi, he said, kul, eat from everything, order. If'al. This is what Allah said. This is training him. If'al, little exam. I'm examining you. Eat from everything. Miss kul, eat, is order. If'al. Tayyib. Wala taqraba, don't come near to this tree, except to this tree. Means inahi, don't. And this is the Islam. Do and don't. That's it. This is the whole entire message. For Adam, he'd been trained in that Jannah for one question, just one action. Kul la taqrab. Eat from everything and don't come near to that tree. That's it. This it was the exam of Adam. And he was in big failure, Taman, of course. Shaitan deceived him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, لا يفتننكم الشيطان. Don't be deceived. Like the way Shaitan deceived your father Adam. And when they ate from the tree, they saw their shame, Adam and Eve, their private parts. And Allah showed them their sawah. Subhanallah, private parts. And Allah is telling us also, here, this is al-aqabat. Al-aqabat. We have too many ups and downs while we're being examined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah declared it in Surah Taha. He said, وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَى. Adam already disobeyed Allah. طيب. After that, he made tawbah. He disobeyed Allah and he made tawbah. He repented. And Allah gave him the kalimat. Even he said when he made tawbah, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. After that, when he came to this earth, ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَهَدَى. Allah has chosen him as what? Sheikh Sha'rawi said, as a prophet and messenger. Sheikh Sha'rawi was mistaken. Yes, Adam was just a prophet. He was not a messenger. No, you cannot claim that he was a messenger. Adam just only was a prophet. Yes. And the first messenger was Nuh alayhi salam. And any messenger, he's a prophet. But not any prophet is a messenger. You got it? Yeah. For Adam was a prophet, not messenger. Nuh, he was one of the five messengers of power. Ulil azmi min ar-rusul. Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah mentioned them in the Quran. They were the messengers of power. They were the most being examined by Allah. And their exam was so hard, even harder than the exam of Adam himself. They've been examined by their people. Musa, look what he did with Bani Israel. They give him hard time. Sayyidina Ibrahim, the same thing. Since he was young, they put him into the fire. Sayyidina Nuh, 950 years making da'wah, the flood. Sayyidina Isa, they've been teasing him and they want to kill him. Subhanallah. See, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw also 23 years azab, punishment from his people. See, these, they were the messengers of power. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Bani Adam, children, be careful, be away from shaitan. Shaitan, he did not listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not make tawbah, but Adam made tawbah. And shaitan threatened Adam and his descendants, said, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ. Oh Allah, he swore by Allah's power and izzah, dignity. لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. وأنتم تعرفون تجربتكم مع أبي. You know how Shaitan deceived your father Adam, that he get him out from Jannah. Allah give him تكليف. والشيطان, who's a Shaitan? Any Shaitan كافر. طيب, any jinn كافر? No, you cannot claim that any jinn كافر. Any Shaitan كافر, متمرد. But not any jinn كافر. الجن, they have, some of them are Muslim, some of them not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنَّا مِنَّا الصَّالِحُونَ وَمِنَّا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. يبقى الجن, some of them صالحون, pious, and some of them, they are not. And they are too many. أَفَتَتَّخِذُونَهُ وَذُرِّيَّتَهُ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِنْ دُونِي وَهُمْ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ بِئْسَ لِلظَّالِمِينَ بَدَلًا. So we have to understand that any shaitan kafir, but not any jinni kafir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ. The problem of the shaitan with us, the devils, they can see us, but we cannot see them. We are stronger than them, because our body has كثافة, has, يعني, it's heavy, has weight. But they don't have, they've been created from the flame of the fire. But the fire can burn our body. Be careful. And the shaitan can be transferred to a human being for a second, little time. يعني الشيطان can come to you like an animal, black dog, black cat, black snake, black donkey. Can come in the form of a human being, very ugly, bad, but just for little second. Otherwise, he cannot stay more. Otherwise, going to be killed. He's not powerful. He has no power like al-malaika, for example. Malaika being created from light. And the malak, he can come to you as a human being, but he can stay more. Who said that? Jibril alayhi salam. Jibril alayhi salam. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa in the form or the shape of one of the Sahaba. His name was Dihya al-Kalbi. And he stayed long. Sayyidina Jibril, who was asking Rasulullah and the Sahaba about Islam, about Iman, about Ihsan, about the minor signs of the Day of Judgment. And he was asking Rasulullah, answering, and Jibril saying, you're correct. And suddenly when he finished, he disappeared. And Umar ibn al-Khattab said, Ya Rasulullah, where is the man? He said, this is Jibril. He came to you to teach you your religion. And he used to come to Rasulullah while he was in his house in the form of Dihya al-Kalb. The Sahaba, they used to think he's Dihya. That Sahaba, he was very handsome man, you know. But he was not. He was Jibril alayhi salam. The Malaika, they can come in the form of a human being and they can stay longer. But Shaitan or the jinn, they cannot. They can come to you in the animal, whatever, but they disappear very fast because they are very weak, they can die. But this is their problem. And the problem is, again, Shaitan, he's giving secret talks, whispering. And he's scaring you, and he's looking for those who are naive first. He's playing in their mind, and those who have no iman. These people, they are very light. Shaitan can easily deceive them. But if you are mu'min, you are strong, you have iman, the iman in your heart like the mountains, you know, rooted in your heart, shaitan cannot do anything for you. That's why shaitan, he said, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Those who are sincere, I cannot do anything to them. Those who are sincere to you, ya Allah, مخلصين, they have sincerity, ikhlas, I can do nothing to them. But those who are weak, naive, they have no iman, and those who are away, these people already, يعني, subhanAllah. But I said that before, shaitan is not going to the bar, is not going to those who are disobeying Allah, okay, already, because they are already there. He is not looking to them. Shaitan is coming to us here in the masjid. He's standing outside the masjid. When you make the iqamah of the salah, he's coming to blame your mind and telling you a lot of things. That's why you see Muslims, they are fighting in the masjid, arguments in the masjid, doing a lot of problems in the masjid. Why? Because this is shaitan. He said, those who are in the bar already, they are out of my hand. Ma'as salam. Khas kam. Fidahya takhukum. You are in the hellfire already. Khalas. This is what already you went yourself. But I'm looking for me. This said Jum'ah and this is man, this man, this man. I'm looking for brother Umar. He's looking for Sheikh Umar. 50 to 40, whatever. 60. This is up to you. Yeah. And the shaitan, like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this ayah here, سبحان الله. He said, إنا وقبل حد إنا جعلنا الشياطين أولياء للذين آمن للذين لا يؤمنون. الشياطين, they are helpers, lies, أولياء, friends to those who not believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. They are يعني سمنا على عسل together. وبعدين الشياطين مشكلتهم صعبة كمان. الشياطين, what they are doing. شياطين الإنس, شياطين الجن, they are so jealous of you when you come to the masjid, when you worship Allah, when Ramadan comes. That's why you see, for example, in our Middle East, they are working, those who are calling themselves actors and actresses. They are working all the year to make series, to make movies, to make a lot of things. And they produce these things just only in the month of Ramadan. Working 11 months, just spending millions. Imagine that 500 tamsiliya or musalsal series in the Arabic TVs. 500 every year in Ramadan. Plus the movies, plus the fawazir, plus a lot of programs. Why? عشان نتسلى. I want you to enjoy while you are fasting Ramadan. To enjoy what? Seeing bad words, seeing astaghfirullah azim wa rab. All shayateen working all the year just to produce and to introduce this to you in the month of Ramadan. He wants you, remember 2006-7, the Turkish series, they call it Muhannad and Nur, if somebody remember that. I was in Louisiana. Some ladies, they used to put it during the time of Taraweeh. Some ladies, they stopped coming to Taraweeh and some brothers. Why? I want to watch Muhannad and Nur. Rabbana yakhdak into Muhannad and Nur, ya Shaykh. It was a Turkish series. And all Middle East, all Arab, they used to leave that TV, the Ramadan, Taraweeh, and everything. They want to sit, I want to see what happened to Muhannad and what happened to Nur. This is exactly what happened. 2007, I was Imam in Louisiana. These people, some of them, they divorced their wives. The man came from the war. He found Roj on the TV. Roj, and he asked his little girl, yeah, he's in America. From this Roj, he said, Baba, Mama, she was watching Muhannad and she was kissing him. during this. And she said, what divorce? Yalla, get out of here. Yes, it's a big fitna. These people, they are shayateen. Wallah, they are shayateen. فذات سوى الله سبحانه وتعالى said, يا بني آدم لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة. Don't let shaitan deceive you. Likewise, the way he deceived your parents and he get them out of Jannah. Be careful. Allah is warning us from shaitan and from those who are following shaitan. يا جماعة يعني سبحان الله, very important. Also, let's see this ayah, number 28. It's related to another one. وَإِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا آبَاءَنَا وَاللَّهُ أَمَرَنَا بِهَا. Look, قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ وَسَلَامُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءَ أَتَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Look at this ayah, this verse. When they do something shameful, who? The people of Quraysh, Mecca, during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When they used to do something shameful, something bad, they used to give themselves excuses. There is nothing called you can be excused if you make anything haram for any kind of circumstances. No. Like I asked that man in Louisiana, brother, you are in America, actually, alhamdulillah, Allah has given us too many opportunities here. You are in the, mashallah, the ground is big and what, you can make any business halal. He said, no, they are selling khamr, alcohol, grocery stores, and doing all haram. They said, brother, we don't have anything. This is what we learn. This is what we know, nothing else. I said, no, this is not an excuse. Your kids, they will never going to be hungry here in America. Yes, if you want to be hungry, this is up to you. But nobody going to be hungry in America. You know, maybe in your country you will be hungry, but not in America here. American people, they are take care of you. But if somebody want to be homeless, this is up to him. These people, they think these homeless people, the government, they are not helping them. They are helping him. They give them shelter, but they doesn't want. They don't want anybody to tell them, sit down and stand. They don't need to, most of them, they are psycho. They are crazy, you know. That's why they live like this. Wallah. The government, they are giving the refugee, those who are coming to this country, they are supporting people. But these people, no, don't blame the government. Blame them. Mama, they are like this. If I'm telling you, brother, don't have any excuse to do the haram. There is no any excuse for them, the haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna ask you. For these people, they try to put too many excuses. When they do something shameful, such as evil deeds, going around the Kaaba while they were naked. They were naked. Do you know what they used to do in Mecca? They used to claim they had honor. They said men, they can make tawaf around the Kaaba naked, completely naked. And okay, what about the turn of the woman at night? And they leave the Kaaba open for women at night, women naked too. They make tawaf around the Kaaba. That's why, yes, it was shameful act during the time. Imagine that. And how they used to make tawaf? They used to say, Ya Allah, labbaik, Allahumma labbaik. Whistling and clapping. Whistling and clapping. This is their salah around the Kaaba. مَا وَمَا كَانَ صَلَاتُهُمْ عِنْدَ الْبَيْتِ إِلَّا مُكَاءً وَتَصْدِيَةً. This is the meaning. Whistling and clapping their hands around the Kaaba. Imagine that. And subhanAllah, is that the prayer? And the naked women at night. Naked men during the day. This is what they used to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا أَبَأَنَا. The meaning here is we used to do that things or any kind of fahisha. And fahisha in Arabic, when you hear this word in the Quran, means zina. Zina. Do you know what is zina? Because any kind of major sin, it's harm gonna go to the person himself, not to somebody else. How? You drink al-khamr, you're gonna harm yourself. You do the riba, harm yourself. That is zina, no. Zina, somebody is sharing with you. That somebody can be pregnant, child from zankha, from haram, and maybe they can kill this child, and the child gonna go to the society, son of zankha, haram. A lot of things, a lot of harm. That's why zina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is called it fahisha. Fahisha, yani something major, something very bad. And the sexual intercourse, they used to say, we found our fathers doing it. Look, excuse. And Allah has ordered us to do it. Do you think Allah asked them to do that? Astaghfirullah al-Azim. قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, oh Muhammad, to them, Allah never orders anything shameful. No, astaghfirullah. Allah is telling us, this is haram. Don't do it. One time I asked a man, he was in jail for more than 35 years. He was about to kill his family and wife. And I went to him prison to visit him for like 8 years ago. I said, brother, why do you do that? Yani, we stay. He was a big gang in jail. Even when they used to punish somebody in jail, they used to send him to kill him.
And that man, I know him personally. You know? He's Arab. I went to him after I get out of jail to visit him with some brothers. And subhanAllah, he was very strong. And subhanAllah, what happened is, he said, Sheikh, if I kill somebody, this is, it's written. This is the way I kill him. Allah written this for him. I said, no, I don't think like this way. It's written. You look what he said? Like the Qadariya way. Why you cut the hand of the thief while it's written for him to? They said like this, or the Jabriya sect, or the Qadariya sect. He's majboor. He's been forced. It's written for him. No, Allah give you a choice. Don't say that. Even Iblis, he had a choice also. Malaika, they have no choice. But Iblis himself, he had a choice. That's why he chose, I don't want to bow to Adam. And he rejected the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't tell me I have no choice. You have a choice. And again, I tell you, even if it's written for you, do you know what did Allah write it for you? No, it's hidden. Means you have to go the way you choose. Subhanallah. But more you come close to Allah, Allah will guide your heart. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, Ya Muhammad, Allah never orders anything shameful. Do you say about Allah what you don't know? What you don't know? أتقبلون على الله ما لا تعلمون. We learn from these two ayat, be away from any kind of shameful acts. Be away from any kind of haram. From zina, especially the adultery. And also do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. Remember, Ya Bani Adam, Allah is calling you, oh children of Adam. Means like, Ya Bani Israel, remember your father was Jacob, be good like him. Remember your father was Adam, Ya Bani Adam. And remember his animosity or animosity of shaitan to him. And the shaitan, he promised Allah that he gonna tease you to take you to hellfire with him because already shaitan out of Jannah. And he said to Allah, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ Ya Allah, I swear by your izzah, dignity, izzat, لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ I gonna misguide them all, except those who are sincere to you. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ Shaitan is your enemy. The one who is praying with you in the masjid is not in your enemy. The one is your neighbor, your wife, your kids, they are not your enemy. Your brother in the masjid, he's not your enemy. That's why when a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam one time, start backbiting his brother, talking bad about his brother. And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, brother, أغزوت الفرس والروم. And your brother is not safe from you. MashaAllah, you know, you defeated the Fors and the Rom, and your, mashallah, your brother is not safe from you. Why? Go, he's your brother, he's not your enemy. So be careful, you know, inshallah. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us all from the fitna of the shaitan, from waswasa of the shaitan, ya Rabbil Alameen. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحفظنا وإياكم من شياطين الإنس والجن وأن يثبتنا على الحق وعلى الطريق المستقيم وأن يهدي قلوبنا ويجمع شعثنا ويغفر لنا يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خير